गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी अ टॉपिक डेटा हैंडलिंग इन दैट न्यू पॉइंट सर्कल ग्राफ और पाई चार्ट. ओके, इन द लास्ट ईयर ऑल्सो वी हैव लर्न अबाउट दिस सर्कल ग्राफ और पाई चार्ट. एवरीवन लाइक दिस पार्ट फ्रॉम दिस टॉपिक, करेक्ट ना? व्हाट इज द सर्कल ग्राफ और द पाई चार्ट? ऑफ कोर्स द ग्राफ व्हिच इज रिप्रेजेंटेड बाय यूजिंग द सर्कल, दैट इज द सर्कल ग्राफ और पाई चार्ट. ओके, so data which is represented by dividing a circle into sector. Sector means which is related to the angle. Okay, so we have to divide the circle into the different sectors, means into the different angles. Okay, so it means that we have to show the data which is represent by using or by dividing the circle into the sectors is called pie chart or circle graph. Okay, so this graph, pie chart or circle graph, is the relationship between a whole and its part, that we will see. Okay, so before that we will just revise this. We will see which type of information we will get from this chart. So here this is the circular graph or circle graph, or we can say pie chart. In that, see, this is sectors are given here, this sector and this sector, right? So in these sectors in which we have divided the circle, in that only we know that here, if you see, here is a 90 degree angle, but here we cannot say what is the perfect angle in there. Okay, here we cannot say, right? Only one information it is given, this 90 degree angle is there. Okay, now this is the graph of above the students, different modes of the transport used by the students of a school. Okay, so here the students are going to school by, some students are going by using bus, some are going by walking, some are going by using car, and some are going by scooter, right? Now we will see the different examples on this. Which mode of transport is used at least? At least means only few students are going by that transport. Okay, so which one transport? Here we will see bus having the bigger angle, scooter is the lifting less. Here car, if you compare this to this or this 1, 2, 3, so this is little greater than this angle, right? Again, walking and car, and walking we can compare with the other angles, then this is the less angle, right? So we can come to understand, so which one mode of the transport is used at least? Correct, that is walking. Okay, next question is what? Which mode of transport is like most? Which mode of transport is like most? Which one? This is bus. Correct, because the angle is greater. Okay, here central angle is greater, or this sector is greater than other this sector. Understood? Now next question is here. If there are 1200 students in a school, okay, this total students are how many are here? 1200, and they are divided by using the transport like this. Okay, so in a school there are 1200 students. So they ask the questions, how many students come by car? Okay, so we will see by car which angle is there, how many degree angle is there? 90 degree. Okay, this angle is 90 degree. So the pie chart or pie graph is the relationship between a whole and its part. Okay, so here if you want to find out how many students are going to school by using car, then total students are how many are there? Total students are, okay, 1200, right? And they have done here this car, the students are going by car, that we don't know how many students are going by car, but angle made by this here, how many degree? 90 degree. So we can find out 90 degree by total degrees, how many for this circle? Correct, 360. Okay, so of how many total number of students? 1200. Now we do the calculation. This 9 1 9, 9 4 are 36, 4 1 are 4, 3 are 40, 40. So here, how many students? There are 300 students are there. Okay. Now we will see next point, how to draw a bar, a pie chart or circle graph. So here we need to use, right here, if you want to draw this circular graph, here we have to use a protractor to draw this, right? Now everyone know that how to draw an angle, right? Now, so when we draw this angle, suppose I want 50 degree angle. So where we at point this? So where we are taking the protractor? We are taking the protractor at this point. Okay. If I want to draw here 50 degree angle on this point. Okay. So every angles are drawing by keeping the protractor on this point. Okay. So we have to keep the protractor and from this right to left we have to go 10, 20, 30, 40 and 50. So angle will come like this, right? Now on this is supposed to be the 50 degree angle. Okay, now we will see here. Now we will see how to draw pie chart. Okay, how to draw pie chart or how to draw a circle graph, right? So before drawing any pie chart or any graph about the any data, so first I will show how to divide the circle into the different angle. That is the most important thing is there. Okay, so here suppose to be your this circle. Okay, any different data is given out here. That means after first we have to select center. Okay, so center everyone knows that we can take any convenient radius and we can draw a circle, right? We have to take any convenient distance to construct a circle. We have to draw a circle. Okay, so by taking any convenient radius is this distance in your compass and we can draw a circle. Okay, so any by your choice. Then we have to draw this one of the line segment, that is we have to draw one, this is radius. Okay, then afterwards if you have to draw 90 degree angle, then we will keep the protractor. Now everyone know that how to draw 90 degree angle. What we are doing, we are keeping the protractor here. Okay, on this one, middle point of the protractor is here, central angle, right? And then we are counting from here 0, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80 and 90. So where you will get the exact marking, you have to do this marking on your page. Okay. And then you have to join this point and your this one center. So here you will get 90 degree angle. Okay. Again, if I want 30 degree angle to this point, right, and with this line, then what I will do, I will take the protractor and I will keep like this protractor on this line, not on this, right? So here I will keep the protractor and this angle, this point we have to adjust to the middle point of your protractor and then we have to count from this side, not to downside, right? And we can go clockwise or we can go anti-clockwise. Okay, but once you will go clockwise, then you don't go anti-clockwise. Only clockwise or anti-clockwise. Now I am going anti-clockwise. Okay. So from here, this I have to adjust the protector here. Then I have to start from here. This is the 0 of the line. Then 10, 20, 30. So I will make the marking of this 30. Right. And I will join this point and this point. And I will draw this segment. Okay, so how many degree angle is here? 30 degree angle. Okay, then afterwards supposed to be the 60 degree. Then 60 degree means I have to keep the protractor here and adjust to the middle line and this center to this line and from here I have to count 10, 20, 30, 40, 50 and 60. So 60 will come here exactly, so I have to join. Getting? So like this, if I want 50 degree, again if I want 50 degree, then I mean adjust my protractor here, central point of your protractor and this center of circle I have to adjust. Understood? And from here I have to start from the counting 10, 20, 30, 40 and 50. So I will join this point, center of the circle and this point. Then in this way you will get, right, 50 degree. And remaining, if it is the 130 degree, then this angle is 130 degree. Okay. So 130 plus 50, 180, this 90, this 30 and this 60, 90. So 90, 90, 180 total is 360. Okay. Now, here it is very important to how to divide the circle by using the protractor. Then it is easy to draw a pie chart. Okay. Now we will see with the help of example. Now we will see examples on how to draw or method of drawing a pie chart. Now we will see the example. The main sources of energy used by each house is listed below. Okay. So what sources of energy? What are these? Electricity, solar, gas and oil. And number of houses that are using electricity, like these houses are how many? 20. Solar 10, gas 12 and oil 6. Means 6 houses are using the sources of energy as a oil. 12 houses are using sources of energy as a gas. Okay. Now we have to construct or we have to represent this data in which form? Circular graph or in a pie chart. Okay, now we will see how to do. Right, so for this, to draw this or to represent this data into this circular graph, we have to find the sector. Right, sector is related to angle. We have to find out the sector for each sources of energy. So first we have to find out what is the angle, that is what is the central angle for this electricity. Okay. So here, first we will find total number of houses. Total number of houses. How many total number of houses? 20 plus 10 plus 12 plus 6 equals to 48. Okay. Now you will see what is the central angle for the electricity. Okay. So electricity, for that, I am going to find out what central angle. Okay. So, how many houses are using electricity? 20 houses out of total 48 houses. And we have to find the central angle. So, multiply by mean, the total measurement of this circle is what? 360 degrees. Then, okay. So, here, 4 5s are 20, 4 1s are and 4 2s are 8. Okay. So and 12 1s are 12, 12 3s are 36 and this 12 0, 0. So you will get 3 5s are 15 and this 0. So 150 degree for which? For electricity. Correct? Now we will see for the solar similarly. For solar, what is the central angle? Okay. So solar, how many houses are using sources of energy as a solar? That is 10. Out of total, how many houses are there? 48 into 360. Okay. We have to simplify this. In the 12th table, 12 4s are 48, 12 3s are 36, 12 0, 0. Right? Again, 2 2s are 4, 2 5s are 10. Okay. Then 2 1s are 2 and here 2 15s are 30. So finally you will get 15 into 5. So 15 into 5 equals to 75 degree angle. Right. Then afterwards, next it is gas. Okay. So we find the center angle for gas. Central angle. Getting everyone? Okay. Then How many are there for gas? 12. Out of how much? 48 into 360 degree. So 12 ones are and 12 fours are 48. Then 4 ones are 4, 9s are it is 400. So you will get how many degree? 90 degree for gas. Okay. Now similarly for oil. For oil, we will find out for the oil it is how many houses are using oil as the sources of energy? 6 houses. Then total how many are there? 48. Okay. Into 360 degree, right? 6 ones are 6, 6 8s are 48, right? Then 8 ones are 8, 8 4s are 32. How many remaining from the 36? 32 get cancelled? 4. And this 4 0 40, so 8 5s are 40. So for oil, you will get how many degree angle? 45 degree. Okay, now this information we have to set into this graph, means in a circular graph. So for that purpose, what we have to do? First, what I will do, I will join this center and any point on the circle. Okay. You can join here, 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 anywhere you can get, right? So, afterwards, we have to find the first. Electricity, how much degree angle we got central angle? That is 150 degree, right? So, everyone knows that how to construct the angle of given measurement last from the 4th class we have learned that how to construct the angle, okay. So, I will take the protractor and add to adjust in here the middle point, right, central point. And here this point you have to adjust and you have to count from here. Then this is 0, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80 and exactly will come 90. Then 100, 110, 120, 130, 140, 50, right? Like this. Means that is yours will come different because you will get the accurate measurement by using protractor, right? So how many degree angle? 50 degree. Suppose this is 50 degree, then you have to join this point and this point. Okay. Wherever you will get the 50 degree, you have to mark it and to join the center of circle and this so that you will get 150 degree angle, central angle. Central angle means at the center that angle got. So it is for electricity. Okay, next how many degree? 75 degree. The same procedure we have to follow. We have to adjust protector here by this side. This protector side will come to this side like this and we have to count from here. Okay, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70 and 75 like this. Suppose to be the 75 will come here. Okay, then we have to join this point and this marking of 75 degree. Okay, so this is of 75 degree for which? For solar. Okay, then now afterward again you have to follow the same procedure. Here you have to adjust your protector and exactly 90 degree you have to construct for gas. Okay, so from here to here suppose 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80 and 90 here you got. Suppose to be you got here 90. Then you have to join this center and this so that you will get here 90 degree angle. Then here you have to write and what is for gas and remaining there is no need to count, it is automatically what will be there 45 degree for which? For oil. Understood? Now we will see once again one more example to construction of a pie chart. Okay, now we will see the next example. When the graph is given like this, means percentage are given only, not a single how many students, means what is the information given about that there is no any measurement of it is given. Okay, so we have to find out. So we will see this example. The figure shows the food liking of 1080 means 1080 students of a school. Read this graph and answer the following questions. Okay, sometimes graph is given, we have to answer the given questions. Okay, so see here, how many students like to eat chapati? Okay, so first we will see the graph. In that, this angle for the rice, central angle for the rice is not given. Here, angle for the pasta, it is given how many degree? 45 degree. Okay, then angle for the pizza, it is given also 45 degree. Here, dosa 60 degree, chapati 120 degree. Can you guess how many degree angle will be here? Yes, if it is passes from the center of circle. Okay, if it is passes from the center of circle, or you can see the round side, this angle 120 and plus 60, how many? 180. It means this is the semicircular part and this is semicircular part, right? So 180 and 180 total 360. So from that 180 it is completed outside, right? So remaining this 45 and this 45, how many degree? 90 degree. So for to make the 180, how many remaining? Now 90 degree, because if this 90 degree and this 90 degree, 180 and this 180 degree total, right? So you will get 360, or you can use the angle sub property, no problem, right? So finally this you got here 90 degree. Understood? Now here 90 degree students are like to eat rice. Here 40 degree pasta, here 45 degree pasta, 45 degree pizza, 60 degree dosa and 120 degree chapati. Okay, but here we don't know how many particular students are like to eat chapati, how many particular students like to rice, then pasta, pizza and dosa. Okay, in the previous example, the number of students or number of houses, in the last example, number of houses were given, right? Electricity and means and number of houses. So number of houses using the sources of energy like this group, right? So particular number was given. Now here central angle is given. Now we have to find this 690 degree central angle, means what is the particular number or how many number of students that need to like a rise. Then this and this. Okay. Now see here total number of students are given. How many total number of students? 1080. Okay. Now we solve this one by one. First we will find all this for the rice, for pasta, how many students like to rice actually, how many students like to pasta actually. Okay. Now see 90 degree from how many degree total angle? 360. Okay. So for first we will write for the rice. Okay. So rise 90 degree upon total degree of angle, it is how many? 360. Of how many total number of students? 1080. Okay, 1080. Last time what we have done? We have taken here the houses that are using the electricity as an energy source. Out of how many total number of houses? That 48. Into multiply by, we have to find the central angle, so we will take the whole measurement, it is 360. Now here it is different, here measurement of angle is actually central angle is given and total number of students is given. Then we have to find what is the particular time numbers of the students. Okay, so here this 00 get cancelled, 9 4 are 36, then you will divide this 4 1s are 4, 4 2s are 8, how many remaining? 2. Then 4 7s are 28 and 4 0, 0. So for rice, how many students are there? 270 students are like to eat rice. Okay, or they like rice. Now second we will find out pasta. Okay. So for pasta, what is the degree of angle? Central angle it is given 45 degree, total measurement of angle is 360 degree into 1080, total number of students, right? Then 9 5s are 45, 9 4 are 36 and 9 0 0. Okay, again 5 1 are 5, 5 8 are 40. Okay, then here 8 1 are 8, how many remaining? 2, right? Then 8 3 are 24, right? How many remaining? 4, and 8 5 are 40. So you will get here 135 students are like to eat pasta. Okay, then third, pizza. Okay, so pizza for how many degree angle? 45 degree. So same. So here 45 degree upon 360 degree into 1080 equals to, you will get 135 students. Okay, the same, because degree of angle is same. Then the number of students, they like to pizza, and number of students like to eat pasta, they are both are same. Okay, now here we will ask for the dosa, then fourth. So for dosa, what is the degree of angle? 60 degree, correct? 60 degree upon 360 degree into 1080. Okay, this 00 get cancelled, 6 1 are 6, 6 6 are 36, correct? Now here 6 1 are 6, how many remaining? 4, 6 8 are 48, right? And this 6 0 0, so you will get 180. Okay, now next for chapati. For chapati, okay. So how many degree angle here? 120 degree total of 360 degree into 1080. Okay. So this 00 get cancelled. 12 ones are 12, 12 threes are 36. Then again 3 ones are 3, 3 threes are 9, 1 remaining, 3 6 are 18. Then 3 0 0. So here you will get 360 students. Okay, now 10, we can find out the answers of the given questions. Here, how many students like eat chapati? How many students like eat chapati? How many? 360, correct. So here we write how many students like to eat chapati, that is 360 students. Okay, understood everyone? How to do this? Then here, how many students like to eat rice? For rice, here how many students like to eat rice? Here the question is, next, how many students like to eat rice? So how many students we got here who like to eat rice? That is 270. So we write here 270 students. Okay, next question is, how many students like to eat dosa more than pizza? Now means we have to compare to pizza and dosa. Okay, how many students are like to eat dosa more than pizza? Now pizza how many? 35, and here this 180. So we have to find out how many students like to eat dosa more than pizza. So we have to find the difference. 180 minus 135, so 10 minus 5, 5 will get here, then 8 minus 4, 4 and this minus 0. Okay, so you will get answer what, how many students like to eat dosa more than pizza. So here 45 students. Okay, what percentage of students eat pasta? Okay, what percentage of students eat pasta? So we have to find out the percentage of this. Okay, so everyone knows that how to find the percentage. Okay, see here 135. The students 135 like to eat pasta. Out of how many students? 1080 means 1080, and we have to find the percentage. So multiply by 100, correct? this 0 0 get cancel, then here this number 5 plus 3 8 plus 1 9 means this number passes test of divisibility by 9 and this also number passes the test of divisibility by 9. So 3 we can take as a here 3 4 are 12, 1 remaining 3 5 are 50, and here 3 3 are 9, 1 remaining 3 6 are 80. Okay, then here 2 5 are 10, and here 2 1s are 2, 2 8s are 16, correct? Then 3 6s are 18, 3 1s are 3, and 1 remaining 3 5s are 15. So here 15 5s are 75 divided by 6. Okay, so if we will carry out this calculation, 75 divided by 6. So you will get how many? 6. You have to carry out like this division. 75 divided by 6. Okay. So 6 ones are 6. 1 remaining. Then 5, 6, 2s are 12. How many remaining? 3. Okay. So you will get here. By which number we have divided here? 6. What you got here? 12. And how many remainder? 3. Okay, now here 3 1 are 3, 3 2 are 6. So finally you will get 12 integer 1/2%. Okay. So how many students, what are the percentage of students at 12 integer 1/2%? Understood everyone? Now like this we have to solve the more examples on to construct the pie chart, and from the given pie chart we have to answer the given question.